The Lord.
The Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is here.
brothers and sisters, if there is any encouragement in Christ, any solace in love, any participation in the Spirit, any compassion and mercy, complete my joy by being of the same mind, with the same love, united in heart, thinking one thing. Do nothing out of selfishness or out of vainglory. Rather, humbly regard others as more important than yourselves, each looking out not for his own interests, but also everyone for those of others. The word of the Lord.
Magandang hapon at maligayang adopting Hawthorne, K. Rose, Ina Nonkapiti Dama Marie, from Atlanta, Georgia, another southern state. Ni hao. Hualing. To Sister May, Sister Moy, Brother Charlie, from Toronto, Ontario, Canada, North America. To all our sisters, family, and friends, especially Dr. Chow. On behalf of Mother Marie Edward and all the Hawthorne Dominican sisters, a warm welcome to Rosary Hill to all of our guests. Like many places in our country, if not our world, we are making up for the lost celebrations of last year, which we couldn't have due to the coronavirus. Perhaps one good thing resulting from it all is that we get to celebrate some things twice. Happy 25th and 26th anniversary for Jubilee. It's been interesting, if not actually exciting, isn't it, to see things that we so easily took for granted and lost now return. I don't know about Louisville, except for Churchill Downs, or Atlanta, or Toronto, but there are all kinds of reopenings in New York, from the reopening of Broadway, the opera and ballet at Lincoln Center, Yankee Stadium, Carnegie Hall, even the Carousel in Central Park. And all kinds of social venues marking our experience of life. But I must say that there is nothing so marvelous to compare with what we are celebrating here today. Only when our masks are removed from our eyes and we behold the face of God will we know what a unique creation each human being is. As we pray to Our Lady every evening, and after this our exile, our earthly lockdown from beatitude, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. When I say there is nothing else so marvelous than what we are celebrating here today, I am not exaggerating. On the human side of things, each of our sisters can tell us the story of how she came to be a Dominican sister of Hawthorne, each unique, because each vocation is unique. A Filipina Georgia peach from Bicol, southern Luzon. A daughter of Our Lady of Sorrows, and later our Dominican St. Louis Bertrand Parish in Louisville. A Chinese Buddhist from Calcutta, India, Canada, and Brooklyn, New York. The most marvelous, the most awesome part, however, is what the Lord did. 26, 36, and more years ago. The prophet Hosea describes it very beautifully in our first reading this afternoon, putting on the lips of the Lord these words, I will allure her. I will lead her into the desert and speak to her heart. They probably didn't think they were being allured. rather somehow told. It was different from pursuing a career or raising a family. It meant leaving everything, families and friends, to become a religious sister. That's quite a radical thing to do. It still is, isn't it? In the 1990s, it was not a common occurrence, even in good Catholic homes. The calling is what we call a vocation. And after all is said and done, it was the Lord and His love which drew them here. I will allure her and lead her into the desert. They probably didn't think the nice convent and hospital atop Rosary Hill with its lush green grass, plentiful flowers, and a wide variety of trees was a desert. But it is a desert on both sides of the house. The desert is an interior reality that all of us must come to know. And like the early desert fathers and mothers, one came to the Abba, or in this case, the Alma, and symbolically took off the clothes of the world that one came from and put on the habit of a nun, which would be modified slightly over the years, but still remnant of the 13th century. And from the very beginning, they were given a new name, a veil, and finally a ring. If I may enlarge on the words of the Lord, I will espouse you to me forever. I will espouse you in love and mercy, for these are your fruits, which you will pour out on others, beginning with the sisters you will live with, and the patients who will be entrusted to your care. And know I am always with you, always a hidden presence in them, and in the most blessed sacrament of the altar. I will lead you into the interior desert and speak to your heart 26 years ago and this afternoon. Again, each sister could no doubt tell us her personal desert experience, except it's very personal and private, very arid and bare, and what's more, it still goes on. It's not ended. They learned early on that religious life, and in particular the life of a servant of the cancerous poor, clothed not with the same habit but the same charism of Mother Mary Alphonse of Hawthorne, that the life is a life of sacrifice. A desert, yes, but also an oasis. An oasis which resembles a lush vineyard of juicy red grapes with a few fig trees to be picked. Lots of flowers to be arranged, and even a frog pond to sit by and chat. And they were clothed in the work apron of a vine dresser. We call it a scapular. And over the years, they are pruned and trimmed and formed to do it in a Hawthorne way and pass it on to others. After 25 years, we celebrate and give thanks for the abundant fruitfulness that they have produced, and it still goes on. In the responsorial psalm for today, it says, "You are the king's daughter, and the king is the bridegroom, and he desires your beauty and clothes you in a raiment threaded with spun gold." That's all the virtues of faith, hope, and love, which are also the desert flowers and a bountiful harvest of grapes, to mix up all of our metaphors, like our altar flowers. The sun burst from the orient. The dark, that sister, May. The small, delicate flowers, not quite Sanguinita, that's Sister Alma Marie. And the rich, dark hue flowers, like Kentucky bourbon, Sister Margaret. Very simply, the mystery of a religious vocation to live a life totally given over to the Lord, and in the apostolate of loving service to the sick, is life beyond compare to all the glamorous entertainments of the world. How do they do it? Well, they don't exactly do it. They let the Lord do it. They come to believe in his word. "She who lives in me and I in her will produce abundant fruit, for apart from me, you can do nothing." Says that to all of us. Apart from me, you can do nothing. I've used many images drawn from today's scriptures to describe the lives that we're celebrating today: a desert, an oasis, marriage, vineyard, flowers, veil, and ring. But it's Christ and his grace, his life, and his love that we celebrate, all expressed in one image: the Sacred Heart of Jesus. The sisters unanimously wanted this day to be in honor of the Sacred Heart, because it says it all. "I will espouse you in fidelity, and you shall know the Lord." Thank you, Sister Alma Marie. Thank you, Sister Mary Margaret. Thank you, Sister May. Thank you for saying yes 26 years ago. May Our Lady of the Rosary, our life, our sweetness, and our hope, Our Lady of Rosary Hill, and Mother of Perpetual Help, keep you secure in the heart of her Son. Cor Jesu, salus in te, speransium. Heart of Jesus, salvation of those who trust in you. Miserere nobis, have mercy on us. Heart of Jesus, the hope of those who die in you, have mercy upon us. Heart of Jesus, the delight of all the saints, have mercy upon us. And what shall we pray for you today, tomorrow, and the next 25 years? Heart of Jesus, I trust in you are what desires.
Thank you.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for all his holy church.
Receive our oblation, O Lord, the offering of ourselves, which our sisters desire to reaffirm to them, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, graciously conform them more fully to the image of your beloved Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Sacrifice of or they offer it for themselves and all who were dear to them for the redemption of their souls in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John, and Paul, Cosmas, and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation, and counted among the flock of those who have chosen, through Christ our Lord. Amen. And please, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect, make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and to eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." Pure victim, this holy victim, spotless victim, a holy grail of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation, be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation in the altar, at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith, and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ a place of refreshment, light, and peace. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. To us also, your servants, who those sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us.
As we awake up Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Thank you. body of Christ.
Thank you.
partaken, O Lord, of the body and blood of your Son, which you have given us on this joyful anniversary. Grant, we pray, that our sisters, refreshed with heavenly food and drink, may proceed happily on the journey